Good afternoon, friends. Continuing with our special series of GST on GTA. In this capsule, we are going to discuss today the compliances to be undertaken by specified service recipient who are liable for reverse charge liability on GTA in terms of notification number 13/2017. Then first and foremost, specified service recipient like factory, society, cooperative society, body corporate, any casual taxable person, partnership firm with a registered or not registered including AOP, and any registered person under GST, they need to discharge GST under reverse charge method for services taken from GTA for transportation of goods. Now what they need to do? First of all, they need to raise self-invoice to themselves. Self-invoice in terms of section 31, subsection 3, clause F of CGST Act. And while making payment, they need to raise payment voucher. Now, once they make reverse charge liability at the rate of 5%, they are eligible to avail credit on payment of GST under reverse charge. And what would be the eligible document? Eligible document would be self-invoice generated by this specified service recipient. So this is what the provision pertaining to wattage need to be raised, document need to be raised by specified service recipient. Now credit is available in terms of rule 36(1)(b) on the basis of self-invoice subject to payment of tax, provided they are using these services for their taxable outward supplies. Having said that, next question, time of supply. What is time of supply for discharging reverse charge liability, including GTA? Now, in terms of section 13, subsection 3 of CGST Act, it would be earliest of two dates. Date of payment by the recipient, or date following the end of 60 days, so 61st day from date of invoice would be the point of taxation. So this is time of supply provision. Third, pertaining to this, a prominent question which is being asked, and question is that in case taxpayer has not paid the reverse charge liability of 18-19, and they are now finalizing GSTR 9 and 9C of 18-19. What need to be done? How this reverse charge liability to be paid and shown in GSTR 9 and 9C of financial year 18-19 for specified service recipient? My answer, there are two scenarios possible. The first scenario, that being specified service recipient, you can show your RCM liability in Table 4G of GSTR 9. Corresponding tax liability created in Table 9, which you can pay by DRC 03 along with interest because of time of supply provision, which I said just while ago. And RCM liability will always require to be paid in cash, not through credit account. Now, in a given situation, you are discharging your RCM liability, but next question which is coming, what about my credit? Can I avail credit of this RCM liability of 18-19 paid now along with interest? So, scenario 2 I am discussing. There was one press release issued on 3rd July 2019 with respect to GSTR 9 and 9C. In that press release, it is being stated that you need to capture your RCM liability in the year when you're discharging the RCM liability, because you want to avail credit of the same in that relevant financial year. So having said that, as per this press release, this transaction need to be captured in that relevant financial year wherein you're discharging RCM liability and want to avail credit. If that is the scenario, then scenario number two, you should not capture RCM liability of 1819 in GSTR 9 of 1819. Then what you should be doing? In the current month, I'm talking September 2020. So you should capture your RCM liability in GSTR 3B of the current month, create the liability, pay the liability, and then take credit in the same month. In the month you are discharging your RCM liability, September 2020, so GSTR 3B of September 2020, you will capture RCM liability in table 3 and you will capture credit of this RCM liability in table 4A, provided you are using for taxable outward supplies. But it need to be paid along with interest because of time of supply provision. Earliest of the two, date of payment by the recipient or date following the end of 60 days from date of invoice. So 61st day would be your time of supply in case you haven't paid. So it need to be paid along with interest. So in the current month of GSTR 3B, you are going to capture this transaction, and this transaction is going to be captured in GSTR 9 and 9C of financial year 2020-21, because current month September 2020 going to fall in financial year 2021. So this is what you can pay your past period 17-18, 18-19. 1920 RCM liability including GTA in current month of GSTR 3B. Pay the liability through 3B, table 3. Capture the credit in table 4A of the current month GSTR 3B. It is as per press release issued on 3rd July 2019 for filing GSTR 9 and 9C. Having said that, this was all compliances to be undertaken by specified service recipient for discharging RCM liability in terms of notification number 13/2017. Now what happened in case GTA, who is under forward charge liability for the reason that he may want to charge 12% GST rate or 5% GST rate, or his outward is not falling under RCM nor exempted, so he is willing to charge either 5% or 12%, then forward charge liability. In forward charge liability, when GTA registered, then he has to raise normal tax invoice as required for any registered person under forward charge method. Need to capture in GSTR 1, GSTR 3B for discharging the output tax liability because falling under forward charge method. Having said that, GTA is having option under forward charge either to pick 5% or 12%. If it's picking up 5%, then no ITC on goods and services in the hands of GTA service provider. If it's picking up 12%, then ITC, input tax credit, available in the hands of GTA. But only one condition, he has to pick up either or rate, and that should be followed throughout the year. And as I said, once GTA registered, picking up 12% GST rate, then no reverse charge liability in terms of notification number 13/2017. Having said that, just concluding point in this capsule for all of you, that GTA need to register only when his total outward supply not falling under RCM, not falling under exempted supply, and this GTA want to charge 12% or 5%. So having said this scenario, you have to keep to your mind that 5% with no ITC, 12% with input tax credit, and time of supply for forward charge method would be earliest of the tree under section 13 subsection 2 of CGST Act. What is the earliest of three? Date of receipt of payment by GTA, or date of invoice, provided invoice rage within stipulated 30 days from date of provision of service. Otherwise, date of provision of service. Earliest of the three would be the POT if GTA registered and want to levy GST under forward charge method. So this is the compliance need to be done by GTA under forward charge in case he is registered. So I have discussed in this capsule the scenario of compliances in the hands of specified service recipient for discharging GST under reverse charge method, and second, in case GTA registered and following forward charge method, what all compliances need to be done by GTA when registered and need to comply under forward charge method. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Number of more, you know, component for GST on GTA. So two or three more capsules will be coming up, whereby I'm going to discuss the various scenario pertaining to exemption, when exemption available, place of supply, and the last capsule I'm going to capture the different practical question coming in the market. Like if GTA has charged the rate which is otherwise liable under reverse charge method, what happened if GTA has charged 5% with a reverse charge still applicable? So we are going to discuss multiple questions. What happened if GTA is not issuing consignment note? Stay tuned for different capsule on GTA. So you may continue to watch number of capsule created to cover up GST impact on GTA. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Thank you very much.